Hey guys, welcome back to our 2-Minute Tuesday. My name is Felipe here at Aviator Zone Academy. Today, we're going to be talking about airport safety and hotspots. Hotspots is something fairly new to the aviation field. The FAA recently created these hotspots to identify areas in an airfield that are more prone to incidents or accidents. So let's take a look on our iPad and see what they look like and how we can find more information about them.
Okay, so let's look over at our airport diagram here for Tamiami Airport. And as you can see on taxiway Echo, there's a hotspot. We can see that here with this little HS1. Now the reason why they have HS1 is because some airports have more than one hotspot, and those hotspots are gonna be displayed in the hotspot page, and they'll talk about what the specifics on those hotspots are. A lot of times people just talk about, oh, we have a hotspot on our way to runway 9 right, but they really don't understand why it's a hotspot, and that's what we're gonna talk about today. Where would we find that information? Well, if we go back to the airport pages here on 4Flight, we can see that the FAA has one that's called Hotspot. Now the FAA charts, unlike the Jepson charts are specific to the airport, the FAA are specific to basically almost the state. If you look here, we have all the way from Daytona all the way to Miami. So we're just gonna look right now at where it says Miami, and we see Miami Executive Tango Mike Bravo, that's our airport, and we see HS1. So Taxiway Hotel and Taxiway Echo hold lines are in close proximity to runway 13 and 31. So because of that close proximity, it creates a hotspot, and there's a lot more incidents that happen in this airport. You can see that some airports like Miami International has 4 hotspots, and those hotspots are listed here. It's important to read it over and not just look over the airport diagram and see the hotspot, because sometimes there's some information there that might be useful to you. Now we're looking at the satellite view of that same airport diagram, and we can see that we're taxiing on taxiway Echo here. We get right over to this section, that's 150 feet. 150 feet from the whole short bar is the enhanced center light. And that is gonna give a pilot a warning that, hey, you're getting close to a whole short bar, start looking. And then on the left and right of them, you can see here from the aerial view, we have those warning lights or flashing amber yellow lights that are also there to assist the pilot in identifying where the whole short bar is. Now this area is all under construction because, and runway 13 is actually closed, because we're trying to eliminate this hotspot here at this airport by creating a turn before you actually cross that runway. So the ideal plan for them is going to be that you taxi from Echo, you make a turn this way, and then you have to cross 90 degrees to the runway, and then you can continue runway 9 right. So they're trying to make it a lot harder for you to get there so that you don't make a mistake. Personally, I don't think it's going to be that much of a difference, but they've done the studies and they say that this is the most efficient way to eliminate this hotspot here in our airport.
As a reminder, always use your airport diagram when taxiing around your airport, even if you're familiar with it. You don't want to end up in an aviation safety report. We thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you guys next Tuesday.